May 24th, 2019, I was on a trampoline and I broke my neck, C5 and C6, and it left me paralyzed, lost all movement and sensation below my neck. And hopefully I'll walk again, you know, through stem cells and therapy and stuff like that.
He was at Dallas Children's for 28 days. He was in ICU for 20 of that. We started getting him into therapy. We started identifying places to go where we could get the best, give him the best opportunity, the best tools to get back to some semblance of normalcy. He was working out at React in Addison, Texas. It's where he met Matt Hughes, and Matt told him about BioXcellerator, because Matt had been here.
Probably the biggest thing is just like grabbing stuff. So like if something's on the counter and I want to get it, I just reach over and push it onto my lap or pick it up with both hands and you get it, and like that wasn't something that I could do because this arm was always so not useful. But now that it's moving better, I can use both to grab stuff and move it to where I need it. And that, and then just using my phone, I can use that a lot easier because I used to have pain when I would use it with this one, and then I could use it with this one without pain because this one's working now. So everything was a lot better.
He's gotten a ton stronger since that time. The first time that we came, he was still in the equivalent of a power chair. When we would put him in the manual chair, we pushed him everywhere. He could move it a little bit with one arm, but he really wasn't moving much at all on our first trip down. And now, as you saw, he wheeled himself down the hallway. And yeah, 3 weeks ago, he curled 10 pounds with that right arm that couldn't move. That's huge for us. He wasn't able to initially feed himself. He wasn't able to initially grab drinks or anything like that. But now, as long as we have some modifications, you know, put the drink in a glass with a handle on it or get him some utensils that have, you know, adaptive, little adaptations for them so that he can put his fingers through them. He can feed himself, he can get his own water, he can do things that are, you know, while he still requires help for some things, he can do a lot now on his own. He brushes his own teeth now, which these are things that so many people take for granted, but it's also these little things that make a big difference between, you know, having someone being 100% dependent on other people and being able to do some of these things on your own.
No, I love this staff. They're so nice. I love all of them. They're just like, you can tell they genuinely care about like me, and they're not just doing it because it's their job, you know.